Good morning, Laura and Owen.
Hi.
All right. Well, I'm sure you're anxious to find out, after all this testing, what's going on. So we'll start at the beginning. I think we're finally at a point where we know what's going on in terms of the vision in your eye. Anytime that you start to lose vision in one eye, it's concerning, especially when there's no other sign going on. It's something that's just changing. So Owen, when I look in your eye, what I'm looking at is this inside structure here, and this is your retina that we're looking at. And when I look in there, what I'm seeing is some swelling, edema. Okay? That's not normal for the retina to be swollen and have edema. Because it's not normal for that part of the retina to experience swelling, that's going to cause damage to the cells that are responsible for that sharp, clear vision. After all this testing, it's become pretty clear that what you have is a condition. Leber's is the name of the condition. Leber's optic neuropathy is hereditary. You inherited it. The most difficult part of this is that there really isn't anything we know of that can change the result of this condition. And the other very difficult part of it is, because this is neurological, if it's affecting one eye, it's eventually going to affect the other eye as well.
Does it ever not go to both eyes?
In terms of human possibility, that could happen, that it only affects the one eye. I've never heard of it not affecting both eyes, unfortunately. We can hope that it just affects the one eye, but the likelihood is that we're going to see the same changes starting to occur in the other eye. And the positive step you can take is to prepare for that and to prepare to transition from how you live now to how you are going to live as you begin to lose sight in both eyes. And that is a very challenging transition to make.
Why don't we go on our trip now?
I don't know. You know what? I need to do something to clear my head.
He said that the other eye can go in 1 or 2 months. But we've already been in testing for a couple of months. So it could go at any time. I know. Thanks, Mom. Okay.
Are you kidding me? Of course. I'm available to do it, and I would love to. You said it's a month and a half? Yeah, no, I'm down. I think that would be amazing. For that, yeah, I can definitely clear my schedule. For that kind of money, definitely. All right, thanks. Hey.
Hey. So you still want me to go?
Yeah.
Are you sure?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm sure. I want you to go.
I feel weird about it.
I'm good here. I got everything I need. So go and have fun.
I won't be too long.
Okay. See you in a little bit.
Okay. Love you.
I love you too.
G. A minor. F. Pencil tramps in a prairie dream. Gravel planes on the seesaw runway. Church all day in a pineapple suit. Call it away, repo your ego, ego.
Okay, here's the deal. Something's going on with Owen, and I really feel like I want to get home. Tonight's probably not a good night for me.
Okay. Everything okay?
I'll explain everything later. I feel like I gotta go. Hi.
Hey.
How was rehearsal?
Yeah. Rehearsal? I want to take you to Yellowstone.
Now's not the time.
Owen, this is the perfect time.
Not for me, it's not.
If you're losing your sight, what do you want to remember seeing?
I have to shoot in the morning. I'm going to bed.
Right, tell me what you think of this.
Yeah, it looks all right.
How would you feel about finishing up the shoe for me?
I can handle it.
Sure.
Thank you.
No problem.
Let's go to Yellowstone.
Really?
Yeah, let's go. Let's go now.
Oh my God, honey!
Clutch in all the way?
Yeah. Damn it. Why is this happening now?
Maybe it's a sign.
Oh. Plan B. Prime time. Maybe he'll sell it to us.
Thank you.
I started noticing in this eye just going cloudy, and we went in to get it checked out, and it's just gone on and on. And what they tell me, eventually, this eye is going to go bad too. So Laura convinced me to take this trip to shoot Yellowstone before I go blind.
I'm so sorry, man.
Thank you.
Is there anything they can do?
No. That's the scary part, is it's unavoidable, apparently. It's been hard. Like you were saying, every day I've been trying to wake up and figure out how to make sense of what's been going on with me.
It's hard to make sense of this stuff, man. It seems like things just happen, you know? I mean, bad things happen to good people. Good things happen to bad people. It doesn't make any sense, you know? I think it's just the challenge that you're faced with now, you know? You gotta figure out how to move forward. You gotta figure out how to keep going. Listen, I got something for you.
To be around you both. And I think for Owen too, it's good to be back in Eddie's presence, and he's really glad that Owen's here. What's happening sometimes right now is that I feel like I get in this place and it feels awful, but almost like I blame Owen, even though, I mean, I know that it's ridiculous that this isn't his fault or anything, but, or I'm upset with him somehow, and then I feel totally guilty because of that, and I don't know, I feel like I'm tiptoeing. Am I going to say something too blunt or be too gentle or cross some line and...
mistake?
Yeah. Yeah. Screw it up somehow or not be there the right way for him. It's weird. It doesn't feel like us sometimes, like how we are.
Yeah. I mean, you're going to make mistakes.
Yeah. You are. It's already happened. Four times, at least.
I think that when you love someone, you either are going to fight or flee. And you, I chose to fight, and I think you're a fighter. You know? It's going to work out. Trust me. It's going to be okay.
This belonged to my father. Every single family photo we have, he took with this thing. I've never gotten into photography, but, I mean, it always makes me think of him when I see it, you know. But I want you to take it with you.
Wow. That's quite a gift. Thank you.
Well, you know, I've never been to Yellowstone, so maybe you can snap off a couple photos for me.
I'll do that. Yeah. I'll take some photos and I'll send them to you.
Sounds good.
So how much further do you guys have to go?
A ways. Well, not too bad.
Hey. You can do this, all right?
Thank you. And thanks for this. This has all meant a lot. Good to see you.
Hi. Yeah. What's up?
I don't want to shoot with this.
He's counting on you. I would heal you if I could.
I know. I would heal you too.
Try one with a little bit of a smile. Yeah, baby. About taking the scenic route.
Awesome. help with anything?
No, I got it. Come on, let's go.
This almost reminds me of Colorado. You know? Like going into New Mexico a little bit.
Because of the shadowy mountains?
Yeah. And the colors a little bit.
That trip was amazing.
That was amazing.
What did that guy say when we first arrived in Santa Fe?
In the parking lot?
Yeah.
It was a couple. And they were... We had just finished talking about the desert. And we had just finished talking about... freedom. Like, what that means. And then this couple, we got out after, like, a... whatever, 8 or 9 hour drive, and we literally stepped out of the parking lot or walking toward the bookstore, and they were coming out, and the, was it the man talking or the woman talking?
I remember it being the man
the
talking.
Dude?
Yeah.
And he was telling her, yeah, I wanted to go to the desert and find out what freedom meant to me, or something. We literally stopped in our tracks.
Welcome to Santa Fe.
I know. Land of enchantment. That was the first time you set foot in Santa Fe.
Mm-hmm.
And then Susan dumped the ice water all over your crotch. Another welcome.
That was pretty amazing. I think just the premise of that trip, of you... It was basically destined to be amazing because you set out to go to Santa Fe to give your friend Susan a Bic to shave your head. How could it not be an amazing trip with that kind of setup?
That was good.
And you did it with equal parts tequila and Van Halen.
I think it takes that. Take that, shave your head. Maybe.
Everything's booked up. They've been booked up for months.
What about campgrounds or places outside the park.
I don't know. There's a few more places I can call. Hopefully I can find a room.
The only thing that matters to me is that we're doing this together. I don't care where we end up, okay?
Okay.
I'm gonna go check on the van.
We found that the crankshaft pulley was starting to come apart. That crankshaft pulley needs to be replaced to prevent any further damage. I did an estimate, and I've got the parts on the shelf, looking at about $425 to repair. I can get that done for you this afternoon and have you on your way.
Okay, why don't you go ahead and do it?
Okay, I'll get her taken care of. All I need is an authorization signature right there.
Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hi, I was wondering if you have any availability for tonight. Okay, how about tomorrow? Thanks.
Something I can help you with?
Got this camera. Looking to get a little cash for it.
Okay. Wow. That's dandy. Everything works?
Should.
Case with it and everything?
Yeah.
Well, I could probably offer you around 500. Cash money.
Okay.
I'll go get some money and some paperwork and we'll do it.
All right.
Okay.
Yeah, I was calling to see if you had any availability for tonight. You do? How much is that room? Do you happen to have anything cheaper? No, we're going to take it. That'll be fine. We'll take it.
You've been quiet a long time. Is everything okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
Are you sure?
I don't think I want to really get into it right now.
I want to know.
Talked about it before, but I'm ready. I know. This
This is the worst possible timing.
Laura, I want to have kids too. I gotta ask. I mean, how can I be a good father to our children if I can't see them?
I think that's a pretty lame excuse, because there's so much that a parent can do, and you don't need to see to be able to do that.
Sweetie, I didn't mean to bring it up.
It's nothing. Fine, just... I know it's painful for you to think about that, so... Babe, where's your camera? Owen?
Laura, I sold my camera to fix the van.
What? The van? You sold your camera? Owen! What?
What was I supposed to do?
We're almost here!
Listen to me. It's not about the camera. What did you expect me to do? Huh?
We gotta work something out! It's just the van.
Working something out means spending your guitar money, and that's not gonna happen. Listen. You have to provide for us now. That guitar is everything.
Owen, that was your camera.
Not anymore. Listen, sweetheart, we're here. This is what we came for.
I know.
Camera doesn't matter. Doesn't matter. You want me to drive? Interesting trip.
Yeah.
I'm sorry I didn't tell you about it. I should have told you about it. But I had to. Thank you.
driving all day. Let's just see a little bit of the park.
I don't want to go anywhere.
Come on.
Tired.
Owen, you're not that tired. Here, let's do this. Come on. No, no. I don't want to stay in the motel all day.
Yes, you do.
Give me one good reason why.
That's why.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah. I love you.
No.
No reason.
Come here.
What's up?
It's your turn.
My turn?
Yep.
And I don't know how to do this.
It's just like music. Look around and find something that you connect with. Something that makes you feel more alive.
I like that. Okay?
Find the thing?
Yeah.
Stick it up to your eye? Push down with your right index finger. And advance the film with your thumb.
Which is?
Like that. You got it.
That's it?
You're a pro.
Well.
Most important thing is find the image and tell its story. That's the thing. Good. Very good.
Hey, I think I found something that makes me feel more alive. We'll see how these turn out. Owen?
It's gone.
Baby?
It's gone. I'm sorry.
Baby, no.
I'm sorry.
No. You don't have to be sorry. It's gone. Oh, come here.
Sorry.
Oh, honey.
I'm sorry.
Oh, baby. I got you.
Sorry.
Oh, baby. Let's go.
Okay.
Yeah, and just one step down. There's another one here too. Thank you.
smile.
The distance to tell me where you are.